Dear students, I welcome on behalf of Amity Institute of Organic Agriculture. In the class of Introductory Entomology, today we have practical class. In this practical class, we are going to discuss about collection and preservation of insects. How we collect the insects and how they are preserved in the laboratory. And what is the significance of collection and preservation of insects? The main aim is to know about insect biology. We learn the way of collection, killing, preserving, pinning, use of pin to fix the insect on the board, labeling, different parts, naming of the different parts, and display of insects and their storage methods. These are the aim for collection and preservation of insects. We also know the method of preparation. Why we collect the insect? We collect insect to understand insect biology. What is the habit of the insect? What is the home of the insect? Where they are found? What is the behavior of the insect? We learn different things. We also learn how seasonal incidents of pests are there on the agricultural crops. In different season, different pests are there. They can damage our crops. We learn by insect biology. We also learn insect population. When we collect and preserve the insect, we also learn to know the population. We can calculate the population. We identify the natural image vectors. We can also identify predators, which can be useful for ecological significance. As a hobby, this is also a hobby for collection of insects and preservation of insects. So we use net, that is called insect net. We can make an insect net with the help of a badminton. This is the rod of badminton. This is the circle of the badminton, and there is a net, bag-like net, and these are called butterfly net because butterflies are aerial. They are on the height, they are on the trees, they are arboreal. Arboreal means living on the trees. So we use aerial net to collect the insects which are on flight. Insect like butterflies, moth, dragonflies, wasps are aerial. So we use aerial nets. We can prepare with the help of a badminton racket, already seen the photographs. And there is, we remove the guts and fix with cloth bag. This is called sweep net. This is sweeper. We can sweep with our right hand and the insect can be collected on this bag. This is a small net like structure in which insects are collected. These are the sweep nets. The insects are collected, and this is the field of paddy field. We can also collect these insects from the hill area. There are insects on the ground, so we should be careful to collect these insects. Aquatic deep net. When we are collecting insects from water, these are the nets. We dip the aquatic net into the water and then insects are collected in this net. This is aspirator, means due to suction pressure, due to sucking. From one end there is sucking is done, from the other end the smaller insects are coming into the bottle. From a smaller insects are coming into the bottle, there is a net, here is a net, fine mesh which prevent the insect to come out of the bottle. Insect do not come out of the bottle because of a jali, a net like structure here. Only air can pass, insect cannot pass. So insects are collected here. This is another instrument that is called Burley's funnel. This is a funnel. This is called Burley's funnel. And there is a net on which soil is kept and it is heated. Soil is heated with the bulb. Due to higher temperature, the insects fell down and through the funnel it is collected into the beaker where the alcohol is there and the insect is collected. So Burley's funnel, how to use? It is placed on a wire mesh of funnel over which electric bulb is there. When the soil dries with the heat of the bulb, the insects due to heating they are killed and they fell down into the funnel and they reach to the alcohol which is collected into the beaker. With this way the insects are collected. Baiting. Baiting means eating materials. Insect can eat sugar, rotting fruits, meat, animal dung, other logs. Suppose cockroach, flies, ants, beetles, termites, they came to eat their food materials and then they are collected. They are collected on the rotten fruits, they are collected on the sugar, they are collected on meat and other materials. Trap. Trap means when we trap the insects like with the help of light. Phototrophic insects are there, they love light, they like light, they come to fly on the light and they are trapped. Pheromone trap. Some insects love the smell of the chemical pheromone. They come, especially the moth, Lepidoptera. Moth love pheromone chemicals. They are collected with the effect of a smell of the pheromone chemicals. A sticky trap. Some sticky materials are spread over the board and the insects are trapped on the sticky material on the board. Suction trap. Already said, there is air, moving air is there inside and the many insects are with the pressure come inside the instrument and they are collected. Water pan trap, pitfall trap, gadha. You can see the photographs. This is light and insects are collected in this box. This is lamp and you can see many insects are collected on this plate. You can simply lit a light and you can see many insects are there on the funnel and they can be collected into the beaker. This is pheromone chemical. This is especially used for moths. of the family Lepidoptera. Pheromones are kept inside the bag or inside the beaker, and there the insects are coming inside. They are collected. A sticky board. There are sticky materials on the board, and the insects are trapped. Many smaller insects are trapped. You can see insects are trapping. Their wings are trapped in the sticks, or their legs or their abdomen are sticked here. This is machine, suction machine. Due to inside air pressure, many insects are coming inside and they are collected. They are machines used in developed countries. You can see methyl eugenol. This is especially used for fruit flies. Fruit flies are dangerous for fruit crops like apple, mangoes, and this methyl eugenol is a chemical which is loved by these fruit flies. These fruit flies come to collect hair and they are trapped. Water pan is used for plant hoppers. Brown plant hoppers are collected on water pan plates. This is simple pit. In the pitfalls, many insects are collected automatically. This is called malaise. In the hill areas, there are network like mosquito net, and the insects are collected here, and a large amount of insects are collected here due to large area of the net. Hand picking. Insects which are less active or inactive, they can be collected easily by hand picking, like beetles, grasshoppers. These can be collected. After collection of insects, insects are immediately killed with the help of ethyl acetate or potassium cyanide or other chemicals. Potassium cyanide is highly poisonous. We must be careful about the dose of the potassium cyanide. That is very harmful. So, we should try to use less toxic materials like ethyl acetate, which acts slowly and steadily. How we prepare killing bottles? We use ethyl acetate bottle, about 300 milliliter capacity bottle is there. We pour 1 inch of plaster of Paris, then we mix, then we allow to dry for 48 hours. So this is sterilization of bottle. When the bottle is dry, we saturate the plaster of Paris with ethyl acetate. We add ethyl acetate. We cover it with thick cardboard or filter paper and add few strips of blotting paper or newspaper inside the bottle to keep it dry and avoid condensation of water droplets. Frequent priming with ethyl acetate is necessary for the killing bottles to retain their potency. We add ethyl acetate frequent times to improve the concentration. This is simple method, simply using a jar, and there is vacuum, there is no air passing through that, and the insects are killed inside the vacuumed jar. So, precautions: when we use potassium cyanide, it is highly poisonous. So, it should be out of reach of any children or young students. We use less toxic materials like ethyl alcohol and other alcohols rather than potassium cyanide. Potassium cyanide is more dangerous. When we handle the insect, we should take care of many precautions. We do not mix a small insects with a scaly insects. We do not mix delicate insect with large insects. We use separate bottles for moths and butterflies and another for beetles and grasshoppers. Different varieties, different orders are kept in different bottles. We should not overload the bottles as it can be dangerous. Now, preservation of insect. How insects are preserved in the bottle? Large winged insects such as dragonfly, butterfly, moth are preserved after collection. How preserve is done? To preserve wing coloration, to preserve the color, they are first boiled in water. Boiling in water preserve their colors. Relaxing container. After the insect die, then they are kept in another container that is called relaxing container, in which the body of the insect is spread over. The legs are spread, the wings are spread, and other parts are spread on full size on the board or on the container. We also use a few drops of formalin and carbolic acid. This is also called phenol. This is a relaxing jar is made up of rustless metal, tin or glass, in which few drops of formalin and carbolic acids are there. Over the wet sand, several layers of paper disc are placed. We keep the dried specimen in a small open box to avoid direct contact with moist sand. We close the lid tightly and allow remaining for a day or two until they become flexible. Insect become flexible after death in 2 to 1 or 2 days. Entomological pins. We use pin to fix the insect on the board. They are pointed pin. They are used on the head or wings or on the thorax. It may be made up of metal or pure nickel. And we will see where the pins and how the pins are used. Before pins, we know there is a board that is called setting board. Setting board is used to spread the wings of the insects, especially the butterflies and other dragonflies. These are the methods of preservation. Number one is called dry preservation. In dry preservation, most of the insects are fixed on the thorax. The pin is inserted on the thorax. In dragonfly and damselflies, we use center of the thorax, which is pinned up. In earwig is another insect, we use right tegmen on the wings for preservation, for fixing the insect. In grasshopper, we use midline pronotum thorax region. There is a pronotum, that area is used for fixing the insect. In mantis and cockroach belong to the order Dictyotera, that classes will be after this lecture. Right of the midline pronotum. This is part of thorax. So the pins, most pins are used on the thorax region, whether it is pronotum or metanotum. Pro means upper, meso means middle, and meta means lower These thorax regions are used for pinning the insects, fixing the insects on the board. So you can see bugs are in which scutellum is used, right side of scutellum. Beetles, right elytron. Elytrons are hard forewings that can be used for fixing the insects. Flies or wasps and bees, honeybees, mesothorax is used. In butterfly and moth, center of the prothorax is used. This is the pin. We can see the pin. This is pin and this is thorax region, and these are labeling, naming of the insects, classification of the insects. These are the butterflies where scaly wings can be used, where pins can be used for fixing the insects. Double mounting. When the insects are very small, they are first attached with a board and then another boards are used for labeling, for mentioning their order and classifications. So two boards are used. One board is used to attaching the insect, smaller insects, and another board for labeling. So it is called double mounting. Liquid preservations. We preserve many insects like silverfish, mayflies, aphids, thrips, caterpillar, grubs, and most of them we use 70% ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is used, or methylated spirit is also used. Number third chemical is formalin, 4%. These three chemicals are commonly used for preserving the insects. To preserve the color, I already said we use boiling water. When we boil the colorful insects in boiling water, their color is fixed, their color is not losing now. All the preservatives are highly volatile, hence it is important to use wax and other things to reduce the evaporation of the preservatives. There should be no leakage, that should be taken care with the help of waxing. Label is written with pencil and placed inside the vial. Careful examination of liquid preserved specimens is done once in a year and the liquid is replaced. Liquid is replaced because of it loses the property. Setting. What is setting? A spreading of the wings, a spreading of the legs, a spreading of an antenna. It is called setting. It is a method by which wings, antenna, legs are spread to see the insect carefully. Wings of moth, butterfly, dragonfly, damselfly are set on either side. Grasshoppers' wings on either one side or in alone setted. Setting boards are used for setting before insect become stiff. How to set butterfly? When we are going to set butterfly, we use pins. Pins are inserted on the thorax region. Then wings base is in the label with the top surface of the setting board. Fore wings and hind wings are properly spread on the board and they are also pinned up. Insect is allowed for setting. Setting means stretching their wings, stretching their antenna, stretching their legs so that complete photographs can be taken. Then there is larva. How to preserve larva? Larva are smaller So a method is called blowing. Blowing is a popular method to preserve larva. What is done? This method consists of removing the internal material of larva. The internal content of larva is removed and then we make it like a balloon. We make it a natural size by blowing, by filling the air inside the body. For blowing, we use a small size larva. We also use syringe or needle. These are the detailed method of blowing. We first drown the larva in warm water. Then we took it on filter paper. We cut the end of the larva by a blade. The posterior end is cut with a blade. Then with the help of a roller or a glass rod, the inner material of the larva is made out of the body by the inserting, and then we insert needle in or nozzle, or we completely make to fill the air or other materials are filled into inside the larva, and we inflate the larva by air or other materials. Then it is called blowing. Labeling. Below the insects there are another boards. They are labeled. They are labeled with taxonomic positions. What is the systematic position of the insect? That is mentioned. This is the display board in which many insects are kept. We can see many insects are there in this board, and they are looking like herbarium. We also use naphthalene ball mounted on pins to repel museum insects. This is done by hitting the head of the pin in flame and pressing it against a naphthalene ball. Naphthalene flakes can also be kept in envelopes and pinned in the boxes. Paradichlorobenzene crystals can also be used, which will not only keep off museum insects but also check infestation. These chemicals are used to preserve the materials. CCN mixture, that is creosote chloroform naphthalene mixture in 2:1:1 ratio, is also used as disinfectant to make antimicrobial, to make the box antimicrobial. And preservative liquids and effective to protect the insect specimens in the box. These chemicals are used to protect the insect body from decaying or from decomposition. This is another instrument that is called Ricker mount. You can see the instrument. This board is called Ricker mount. In here a butterfly is fixed inside the Ricker mount. With this we come to the end and we will discuss in details.